Hi, Lou from Orchard Forest School here. I've come inside today because it's so miserable outside, a bit wet and windy, and I thought we'd get more done inside today than me sitting outside on the patio in wet weather gear and everything blowing away. So what I want to show you today is more activities you can do with one of these sticks that's a Y shape. If you remember the other time we made our little man, there he is, he's still there. Can you see him? He's still my friend, he keeps me occupied. But today, what I thought is there's two more activities that you can do. And one is a really simple activity of decorating your twig. And so it'll end up something like this. And then once you've decorated it, you can hang it up in the garden or in bedrooms or wherever. So it's something that will keep the kids occupied for a little while. And it's really good for hand and eye coordination. And all you simply do is get some wool. I've been lucky enough to have some multicoloured wool, which was brilliant when the shops were open. That was, I think, £1 for 3 balls in Poundland. So I was really lucky with that. Obviously, it won't be open now, but you can order wool on the internet. But what you start with is just tie a little knot on the end and then simply wrap it around, keep wrapping and wrapping, going with the shape of the twig and the structure of the twig. And you'll see that I've had to avoid a couple of little bits sticking out there and there, but you can wrap the wool around that, so that doesn't matter. And like I said, it would keep the kids occupied for a bit. It's quite mesmerizing. It brings stress levels down. I've really enjoyed doing this. So what I'll do is I'll carry on doing this because you really don't want to sit there watching me doing this. I'll carry on and then show you at the end of this video what it will look like. So that's one activity you can do. Again, with the same shape twig. And again, you can go on your exercise walk and find twigs like this all around. Give the kids something to do, something a bit different to look for, looking at the actual structure of the twig rather than just picking up a straight twig. The next thing you can do is wrap some wool or string around the structure of the main two V-shape twigs there, the lengths there, and keep wrapping it around and it becomes a scavenger hunt. So for the following day, what you can do is go out on your exercise walk, take it with you, and the kids can find the treasures that they want to thread into it. So I'm just going to do an example. I've got a feather there, so I'll thread that one in. I've got a bit of foliage from the garden. If you're not going out at the moment on walks, and obviously if you have got a garden, if you're lucky enough, then you can find bits and bobs in the garden. And I've got another feather there. So again, it's great for hand and eye coordination. It keeps the kids occupied, and then they've got something to show for their walk. And you can take it out and start again each day if you wanted to, but it gives the kids something else to focus on when you're out and about on your exercise walk while we're all on lockdown. So two different activities to do. I'll get back to you in a minute with my finished activity. So see you in a bit. Okay, so I've finished wrapping it around as far as I can go, really, because you can see the end of the twig there. I've got a slightly longer end there, which I'm going to snip off in a minute, but there's my end of my wool. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to finish it off by tying it off at the bottom, just to secure it so it won't unravel. That's the last thing you want after all the effort you've put in wrapping it around. So snip it off, there we go. And then this little bit here, I'm not very keen on that bit, so an adult will be able to do this, but with some secateurs, remember you can't use scissors for that, because the scissors won't, the blade won't cut through it, it'd be too thick for scissors. So you're going to need some secateurs if you're going to cut any form of wood. And there we go, that's my end product. What I'm going to do then is get another bit of wool and just tie it at the top so I can hang it. But of course, you don't need to hang it. You can lean it against something in the house. But I think I'd like to hang this in the garden. And at Orchard Forest School, we could hang these in the trees in the Enchanted Garden. They'd look really pretty. And of course, with lots of different colours, it would look amazing. So if you want to do any, get them done. And then when we reopen, bring it to Orchard Forest School and we can hang them in the trees in the Enchanted Garden. That will look fabulous. Okay, so go off, have some fun. Find your Y-shaped twig first. And then, like I said, there's two things that you can do with that. And of course, if you haven't done your little man, you've got your little man that you can make as well. So have fun, stay safe everyone, stay indoors in this wet weather, but there's lots of things you can do indoors that's all forest school themed that will keep you occupied as well. All right, see you soon. Bye.